Hello, welcome again. We are covering some theory of strength of material. The topic is taper bar. So consider a taper bar having a larger diameter as capital B and smaller diameter as small b. So extension in taper bar cannot be found out straightforward by dividing it by dividing load by area and then dividing it by E and multiplying by length. So because here the diameter is different, so here the diameter is capital D and here the diameter is small d, so we need, we don't have a particular area to divide with P. So what we'll do, we'll take a strip in between these two diameters and find out its extension and find out the relation and then integrate it to find out the extension in the taper bar. Suppose this is your taper bar and its diameter is capital D here and small d here. So now take a strip at a distance x from one end, from this end, and its thickness is dx, and the thickness of the strip is dx, and diameter of the strip is d. Okay. So now this load will be same throughout the bar. So on this strip, the load will also be same, so that is P. So the stress on the strip will be a P by the power V square. Okay. So strain on the strip is E divided by E. When it is strain, 4P by the 4P divided by pi V square by E. And a change in length of strip is multiplied by dx. So that is strain is multiplied by dx. Then it is change in length of the strip. So now we have to find out the change in length of bar, paper bar. Okay. So now we integrate it between 0 to L. So that is 4px, 4p dx, pi b square e. Okay. So now b is variable and b is small d when it is when x is 0 and it is capital D when it is x is L. Okay. So now we will find out this variation or equation of this variation. So now we can see that dj is, this is your capital D, this is your small d. So this is your dj is your capital D minus d by 2. So this is your d, this is small d, and here will be d minus d by 2, here will be d by 2. So this is your d minus d by 2. And similarly, this fg will also be b minus d by 2. So this is your b, this is your d. So b minus d by 2 here, b minus d by 2 here. Okay. So this is your ga. So b minus d by 2. So now we can see that the triangle djc and fgc are similar triangles. Okay. So from the similar triangle property, we can have gf by dj. GF by DJ is equal to GC by CJ. GC by CJ. So GC is X and JC is L, and this is D minus D by 2 and this is capital D minus D by 2. So we can put this D minus D, 2 will cancel out, D minus D divided by D minus D is equal to X by L. So we can have B is equal to D minus D by L into X plus D. So now this capital D, small d and L are constants. Suppose this is K. Okay. So now the equation of B becomes KX plus D, small d. Now we can put this in the equation of integration, that is this equation. So putting the value of B here, we can have 4P dx divided by pi kx d square by e. Or we can take 4P by pi e out of integration. Okay. So now if we integrate it, then it will be d plus kx minus 2 plus 1, and differentiation of it will be given here. Okay. So it will be the transition of the because it is minus 2 plus 1, so minus will come from this minus 1, and the transition will be in k, so it is k. So integration will be like that. I'm performing integration again. So d plus x, d plus kx minus 2 plus 1. Integration rule divided by whatever we get. We get here minus 1, so we minus 1. And it is also divided by differentiation rule. So this is constant quantity, k is variable, k is also constant, x is variable, so differentiation is k, so it will divide by k. So now the limit of x is l to 0. So now we can take this 4 p pi e k out of integration. So we have left with this only. So now we can put x as l 1 by d plus d minus d by d minus d by l into l. And we put x equal 0, then it is 1 by d. Or we can say it is l will be considered out. So it will be 1 by d. And this d is equal to 1 by d minus 1 by d. Or we can say it is d minus d divided by d by d. And then it will be 4 pl divided by pi d d. So this is the change in length when we consider the integral. Now we can remember the formula directly to find out change in length in the integral, that is 4 pl pi d capital D by D. So if the bar is not taper, bar is circular one, then capital D and D will be same, so that then the formula will be 4 P L pi D square. That is the same formula that we originally had for circular one. So means it is correct. So now this method, this is the method to find out the tension in taper bar, and this taper bar is circular one. So when we have a rectangular object, then this procedure can also be adopted to find out the tension of the taper rectangular bar, and we'll take a strip in both sides along width and along the length, along depth, and find out the expression for A as we will find out for B also, and we find out the expression for the area of this strip, and do the same do by performing the same. So that is the method.